Hello again, this is Miss Lourdes, and today we will be painting a portrait. Edvard Munch's The Scream, that is. This originally is an expressionist artwork created with pastels, oil, and tempera on cardboard, but we will be using watercolor. This is a very famous painting that I'm sure you've seen many times in your life. It has a really interesting story and even has accounts of being stolen a few times. So if you would like to learn more, I suggest you research on it further either before or after this video. This is how your final might look. So let's begin. As you can see, I first created a border on my paper before beginning so that I have a nice clean border at the end. You can do this too with a ruler and some masking tape before you begin. Let's begin with a light sketch, so just follow along. Here I'm planning out where the figure will go, and also where the bridge will go. The lines to make the bridge get closer to each other once they go off the page, so make sure that you do this. This will make it look like it's vanishing, just like one-point perspective. There are two people walking away from the main figure, so I am drawing them here. And now for some details. Once you get to this part, you're basically done with the drawing, so you can erase any lines you don't want. Let's begin painting. I'm going to use this paper to mix some of my paints and also to test out some of my paints. And for the skin of the person, I'm going to be mixing brown and yellow. Next, I'm going to start painting the bridge using orange and yellow. Next, I will start painting the sky using orange. Next, I'll be mixing some blue and brown for the floor of the bridge. For the person's clothes, I'm just going to be using black and a little bit of blue. Next, I'm going to move on to the mountains in the background. So I'm mixing some blues and greens and browns for that. I'm going to be using the same mixture for the water. Next, let's put some yellows in the sky. For this next part, I'm going to be using brown to create lines on the bridge for the shadows of the bridge to make it look more three-dimensional. Thank you. Here I'm using blue to make some line strokes in the mountains and in the water. I'm not using any additional water on my paintbrush, just getting the paint straight from the palette. Here I'm using orange to make the bridge brighter so that it looks like the sunset is hitting it. Fast forwarding, I added some red strokes up at the top where the sunset is, and more blue strokes on the ocean water, and blue strokes on the bridge as well, just as you see here. I'm also just making things darker and adding more detail. Alright, and we're all done. This is how it looks without the tape. I hope you had fun painting with me today. That's it for today. See you next time.